Hi guys, welcome to Watch Hobbyist channel with me, Wayne, and this is just a very, very quick video just to show you a neat little trick that a lot of people don't actually know is possible with Tudor watches. So it tends to be Tudors have quite this unique sort of bracelet clasp system, and this watch here is only sort of just, I've only just received it. So right now it's unsized, and I'll show you my dilemma. So I have quite a small wrist, okay? And I'm just gonna put this on here, and I'm gonna show you. I'll just move the box out of the way so we can see here. So basically what I want to be able to do when the camera decides to focus is obviously size this to my wrist. Now, as it stands, that's how big the bracelet is before I actually go to size the watch. So if what I usually do when I go to size a watch is I sort of put the clasp in the middle of the underside of my wrist. Now, really what I need to do there is remove two links, but that is where the problem starts. So, or so it looks anyway. So basically, there's no issue here. I'm going to show you how to get around this if you have the same issue. But I always like for the clasp to be right in the middle of my wrist. That's where it's most comfortable, in my opinion. But if I go to remove those two links that I was just talking about there, there's a slight issue. So this link here, this third link along, is just a rivet type. There's actually no, there's basically no screws to remove there. That's just a fixed link. And then we have this one which has a screw here, and we have this one which has a screw here. But I need to remove two links. So how do I do it? Well, if I just remove that screw and that screw, that gets rid of one link, but that's no good, that's not what we want to do. So that's where the little sort of trick comes in. Now, you can see here on this section here, which is the sort of bit that I'm moving there, the flip lock, okay, that has a little hole there. And on these newer type of rivet bracelets, the hole is absolutely tiny, so you're going to really struggle to find an instrument that will actually fit within that section, because what we want to do is there's a little spring bar basically holding this on, and we want to actually pop the spring bar out and then remove this. Now, that probably sounds quite technical, and you might be a bit concerned about doing it, but believe me, it's very, very simple. The only thing is that you do risk scratching the watch, which, because I've had to use such a thin tool, I actually managed to scratch it before. But it's only a very light scratch, I'm not bothered about it, it's fine. But you just need to be careful, so maybe use a bit of tape, you know, something along those lines, just to protect it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it off the little ceramic bearing there, because I don't want it locked into place. I want to be able to freely remove this from the spring bar. And most people would have something like a tool like this, hopefully, if you're into watches. This is a Bergeon tool that the actual pinpoint is actually bent. But this is normally fine for removing spring bars and things like that. However, in this case, that's actually too big. So what I had to find was this, which is the smallest, most like needle-like thing that I could find. And that is what I've actually used, or I will use now, just to quickly show you how you actually do this. Okay, so I'm just going to show you, hopefully without damaging the watch any further. Basically, I'm going to now just pop that in to the little tiny spring there, and I'm going to keep it in. And now I've actually released that flip lock, okay, so that's fine. Now hopefully what I'll be able to do is just remove the entire flip lock itself. So that has now come off, so don't worry, that's fine, that's normal, that's okay. I know this all looks very technical. Now we have a little spring bar in here. That is what was holding the flip lock in place. Now, I'm not going to actually do it, but basically what would happen is, if I now want to remove both of these links, as I do, I would take that spring bar out. Okay, so I'll do that bit, that's fine, we can do that. So I'm just spring bar out, okay, and then you will see what happens. So now I can remove those two links, okay, so those can come out, And then this link here, the fixed one, that can go, as this one would, into the clasp. And we would have the ability then to remove two complete links from that side and get the clasp over to the middle of my wrist.